Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Noct, and this is Backbone. So, let's finish this. I think this might be the last episode. Either the last or the one before the last. Artifact. We change, but we change nothing. I'm in my apartment. Time moves through you when you stand still. You are alone. I like being alone. Nobody will ever understand you. You are just a projection inside their heads. I want to be touched. To finally be touched is to be understood, as if a simple act of knowing could reverse the pain. You thought she would be the one to finally know you. I am looking for her. It is your wishful thinking opening up to her this way. It doesn't feel like anything. She was never really there. What is my purpose? To change and to change nothing. I don't want to change. There's always a last time that you see everyone. There's always a never again. I exist again. What? Stale smell of a damn ground, and I swear. And sweat. Where am I? The sole purpose of my existence is so you can gaze upon yourself through me. I'm here for you. I will always be here for you. Gaze upon myself. Your face looks different. Your body is transforming. You are being stuck in a perpetual becoming. You don't recognize yourself, but that's alright. Try to recognize myself. Not much is left of the person you once were. Some parts are still there, lingering, echoes in the caverns deep down that pronounce, I am. I am. I am. Nobody can hear you scream. Who am I? You are me. I am you. Refocus the gaze. Take another look. Let me know what you think. My face. Scars of lives lived, best taken, words pronounced. The newborn flesh is slipping through the seams, discovering the boundaries of what it means to be you. Look deep into my eyes. Your dilated pupils reflect dim light coming from an opening in the tent. Your irises are unstable, liquid spheres of muddy color. Touch my face. Your fingers stick to the surface of your cheek, tissue stretching out as you rip out a small patch of flesh. It immediately grows back. I know who I am. This will not last. Focus the gaze, look at my back. Multiple bulbous tumors are tearing through your shirt, pulsating, hungering for control over your lean, dehydrated flesh vessel. Listen to the tumors. The flesh speaks again, but in a language you can't understand. Refocus. Take another look, let me know what you think. Stumble away. Goodbye, old friend. I will see you again when skies reach the horizon. Goodbye. Go outside. Oh, Larry! Howie! You're finally awake! You had me worried. You've been out for 2 days. Anatoly? Take it easy. What in the shepherd's name was that man? What the fuck is that thing on your back? I don't know what happened. Where are we? We are under the bridge now, among friends. No one knows we are here. What's happening to me? You've been in and out with a bad fever. What's that thing on your back? What does it look like to you? It's a fucking alien. I don't know, like a fucking tumor? Growing from your spine? What the fuck? How bad is it? How does it feel? It's pulsating. It's pulsating, dear me. I don't know, my mind is foggy. What the fuck, dude? How did this happen? I was infected by an organism in a secret government lab, that's how. Sure, you must still have a fever. How can I help? How did we get here? Through the sewers! I found you in the alley, near the dead body. But there were no weapons or anything. You were totally out of it. Did I kill Anatoly? Let's talk about this later, okay? We are going to be alright. Better not to worry. He's dead because of me. Howard, I know you for 10 years. You are not a murderer. I fucking killed him, Larry! Howard, it's not your fault. Please, I want to help you. I'm so sorry. He was my friend, I don't understand. I know, but I'm also your friend. It's going to be alright. We will figure it out together. Calm your tits, Howard. It's a bad dream, it's not real, it can't be. It's honestly best if you don't talk about this right now. You are still in shock. I don't want to make it worse. Are you hungry? I fucked everything up. Calm down, Harry. We are together, and we are safe. I gotta get out of here. Gotta warn her. Who? About what? So connected, the minister, the secret lab. You're babbling, take it easy, Howie. How about a nap? I got to turn here. No. I need to get some air. I can't breathe. Take it slow. It's safe here. Who's Renee? I didn't say Renee. How do you know her name? You're talking in your sleep. I'm scared, Larry. Listen, we'll figure out what to do later. Some will go down soon. We would better get the fire started. Can you walk? What's the point? You can't just lie there and die. Might do you good to have a little walk and find firewood. Ask people at the camp where to get it. Are there people out there? I'm a freak, Larry. They are not going to judge. Introduce yourself, get to know them. This is your new home, after all. Introduce myself? What if I hurt someone? You won't. I'm alright, see? I gotta go run some errands away from camp. We'll make a plan together later. I promise. Sure, a plan. Like, they really worked out the way in the past days, yeah. Fucking plans. We will figure this out as a team. I'll take care of you, but I need to do a thing first. Now go find some wood. Make sure it's dry. Okay. Go outside. Ah, it's Loss. Casey. Heya. I'm Howard. Nice to meet you. Heya, bud. I'm Casey. You been here for long? Long enough? Did Larry tell you about me already? Mm-hmm. Nice meeting you then. Same. Bye. Sorry, I'm just very tired. I know the feeling. Dio? Oh, you're the sick guy? Welcome. Name's Dio. How was the name? Wait, are you the Dio that messaged Rose? How do you know about Rose? And don't fucking lie to me, I will know, and I will fuck you up. I know her mom, Florence. Promised I would try to find her. How did you meet Florence? As part of my investigation into the missing girls. Why? For whom? Speak straight, boy. For myself, I'm a detective. And what were you investigating exactly? Clarissa Bloodworth and her connection to the apes. Well, you're a shitty investigator then. How so? I'm a scavenger, I get people over the wall. Rose is safe, Clarissa is the one sponsoring the whole operation. What? So Clarissa is actually saving people. Clarissa Bloodworth. Clarissa is funding you? We have a deal with her, yeah. She helps get the people out. But she's a fucking murderer. I heard about that. I don't give two shits about where the money comes from as long as I can go outside and help people. Wait, so Clarissa gets rid of no good people to sell the meat to the apes. And then use the money from this dirty money to sponsor helping people escape from the city from the apes' grasp and start a new life. Holy shit, I somehow expected a twist like this, but nice. I'm not quite sure what to say. I don't see anything. I'm not going to discuss my moral compass with you. Get fucked if you don't like it. Rose is safe, what does that mean? She's alive, that's all I can tell you. But is there over the wall? That's not something I tell anyone, sorry. Maybe you'll find out for yourself one day. What about Leslie Pam? Or May Louder? Leslie's with Rose? Mai didn't make it. What do you mean she didn't make it? She was shot on the way there. I'm sorry. Shot by who? Who do you think, Border Patrol? We did what we could, I can't tell you more. I won't relive it again. I'm glad Rose is okay. Yeah, every person out of this shithole is a huge achievement. Do not other folks here know what you do? No. It's not often, but sometimes a girl will wait here until stuff is ready. People know not to ask. That's trusting of you? Not really. I don't leave shit to chance. Can you take me outside the wall? No, don't ask why. In fact, stop asking so many questions. I'm just curious. And I don't have the time for that. So you help the other people escape too? Not as many as I would like. It's a risky process. How risky? It takes months of preparation. A few people are involved, but they can't have much contact. And if we ever fail... You're incredible! It's just something I have to do. Still must be super hard on you. Huh? You're right, it is. Not sure anyone ever acknowledged that. Maybe I didn't even. That's all I needed to know, thank you. Felt good to talk about, actually. Do you know where can I find some firewood? Keep on heading left, it's not exactly a forest, but you will find it. It's nice meeting you. Bye. Bye. These people are interesting so far. This was an accident, I pressed tab accidentally, keep forgetting it actually does something. I wanna check the right side first, because it seems like the firewood is on the left. B. Hey, hey, new guy, excuse me, but are you okay? My name is Howard. B, I'm just doing my scares, don't talk. Honk you later, Howard. Gotcha. Looks very used, smells kinda good actually. Ryan! Sorry, concentrating. Oh yes, hold by. Hello there, old chap. My, you don't look so good. Sorry about that. It's quite alright, chap. Glad you're up. I'm Norse, welcome to the camp. Sorry about me. If you'd like to talk about it, that's cool, but no one here is going to pry, so worry not. I need a third player? I'm afraid this game is halfway through. Maybe we can deal you the next one, or perhaps tomorrow. Cool, good luck. That church kind of building somehow gives me Final Fantasy VII vibes. The church where the cloud falls through the roof of. Okay. So firewood is on the left. Oh. Dry tree. This branch looks promising. Okay, falling asleep. Death is coming to us all. No reason to be uncool about it. I don't want to think about it. It's not like you have a choice. Of course I have a choice. Are you sure? Yes. Interesting. I know you better than anyone, and yet I can't tell if you are lying. All of the answers are the same. You don't know me, nobody does. You can never truly know anyone. Most of all yourself. Time to wake up. I exist. Again. Ah, statue of an ape. I guess the shepherd. That's the tent. Larry. Got food? I see your sense of humor hasn't changed. What can I say? I'm your rock. Steady and dependable. I think the folks here are scared of me. Everyone here has been hurt before. They'll get used to you in no time. I know it. Maybe. I need to get back to Renee soon as well. Renee is the most important thing to you, isn't she? She's my partner and she could be in danger. Doesn't seem like she's trying very hard to find you, so... The fuck you implying? Oh, come on, Howie. Look around you. See who your real friends are. Maybe you're right. Yeah, doesn't happen often. But this time, I think I am. But I can't stay here forever either way. No? Because it feels like you're always finding an excuse to ditch me. Just like back then, when your friend wanted to live with a girl and I had to move out. Larry, I'm so sorry for that, but this really is different. You're really wrapped up in some deep shit, huh? Nice mixed metaphor, and yes. Can you write out? I mean, it looks like you need a doctor. I don't think a doctor can help with what I got. I know you're sick, getting all worked up isn't going to help. Be it whatever you are or you got going on. I know, let's just chill. It's late already. Can we just chill by a nice bonfire? We both need to relax. Okay, fine, but I'm getting out of here tomorrow. Okay, loading. You again? You. Again. I am what I am. You are what you are. I am my past, I am my body, or I am my thoughts. I am my past, because the past defines us, in a way. And what is it made of? I don't remember. Neither do I. It won't matter soon. I'm not ready. You won't ever be ready. Change sweeps you away when you least expect it. And then you have changed, but you change nothing. I exist. Again. Oh, I think it became bigger. Could I wake Larry up? No, I don't want to. Hey, you trying to sneak out on me? He just looks so cozy. Yeah, I'm a regular snuggle bug. You're a regular lazy. What do you mean? What happened to you and that? And what's our plan? Since when it's our plan? Since I dragged you through the gutter for 3 hours? I guess you deserve to know what happened. Yeah, fair the way, dude. Are you sure nobody followed us here? Barely. I dragged you through the damn sewers, however, to go on. Renee and I discovered illegal research at Science City. Something infected me there. Whoa, I mean, I don't even know where to start with this. Can I rely on you, Larry? Fuck, you know I always got your back. But I'm out of my depths here. How can I help? Can you track Renee via sundown? I can ask around my usual contacts. A few of us keep our ears to the ground and trade rumors. But do you have any leads for me? It's a hunch, but check the burning park. If you say so, there's a streety we know who often hangs there too. I'll ask him to keep an eye out. Looney, I met him. Tell him I say hi. Okay, that's a story for another time, I guess. I will do. What's this girl look like? She's a fox. Young, pretty, usually bears green. Okay, I'll see what I can do. You might owe some slightly unusual people a big favor, so. I'm ready to make a decision. Oh, actually, can you get me some meds to treat my condition? I don't know, man. I have a few sources, but do you even know what's wrong with you? There's not a link what I've got can even be cured. Sorry, maybe ask Roger. He's a doctor. Need to find a way to let people know what's happened to me. And then what? Even if they believe you. That's up to them. I will have done my part. If you say so. I'm ready to make a decision. What will it be? I can only do one thing today, but we might try again tomorrow. I want to find Renee. No, I don't want Renee. I would like to see Renee again, but I fear that it might not end well, so I don't want to accidentally kill her. Ask around. Find anyone willing to make an announcement. I know Red ones who run a pirate radio station. I'll start with him. Here too, friend Larry. I'm glad to be. Wish me luck. In the meantime, get to know folks. Maybe help prepare the group dinner tonight. Before I'm invited? Of course, you're one of us now. You should help them out while I'm gone. Alright, see you later, Larry. Dashbonders must stay together. Cork. You must be the horrible mindful ones keep bothering me about. I'm sorry about what happened to you. Sorry if I scared them. Not at all, they're just curious. I'm Carla, by the way, and little terrors are Hugo and Esme. You're handling the kids on your own? Whatever makes you say that? It's your eyes. Like you're ready to take on the world. Damn right I am! But the father didn't leave me, deliberately. No? What happened? He passed away. Oh shit, I'm sorry. It could be worse. The Woobos have a big family to bounce around. People help out, I feel lucky, considering. Planning to stay here? Well, when the kids get older, they're going to want things other than this place can give them. But me? Where else could I go? You don't mind me being around the kids? I know you're poorly, boobs. But what kind of mom would I if I told my kids you were a freak? Well, that's actually quite nice and wholesome in a way. Thank you. I believe in letting my boobos make their own minds up and let them just see you as a person. They're gonna grow up great with a mother like you. Hope so. Not exactly a normal childhood, but seems to be all the normal kids are still unhappy, so... It all starts in childhood. Yes, I suppose so. I'll be on my way, Carla. Bye. And tell me if these two bother you too much. They couldn't possibly. Don't worry about it. Hey. How are you setting in? Try not to. Can't stay long. Oh? I have unfinished business. Hey, most of us do. Sometimes it's best to just let that old life go. I'm not sure I can do that. Anyway, cheer up. Everyone needs some help sometimes. Do you think you belong here? Maybe. In time. But I get tired easily. What makes you tired? It's called chronic fatigue syndrome. Imagine just never knowing when you will need an emergency nap. What caused it? I don't know, the doctor just said I need to pull myself together. How did it end up here? Betty got me fired, couldn't pay rent, then one day, B tripped over me, and boom. How did that happen? She makes little sightseeing trips sometimes, keeps her eye out. Guess I caught her fancy. And if she hadn't found you? Died freezing in a gutter? Nah, I'm lucky. How do you keep your mind busy? I love riddles. I think about life. I notice things. You want some company? If you're not busy, sure. Come notice things with me, tell me what's on your mind, or don't. Yeah, I think I need that. Really? Yay! Sure, it will be nice. Hey Albert, how are you? All the better for seeing you. Yes, I tend to have that effect on people. Need any help gardening? Of course, let's get dirty. Okay, where do I start? Ah, I'm actually gardening. It's like a rehabilitation now. Hello again. What do you make of this place? Good people. Secluded spot, I don't spend loads of time here. But yeah, it works. And the rest of your time? None of your business. I just like to stay on my toes. Everyone here is safe and cool then? Haha, no, they all have their quirks. But they are harmless. Ryan can be a bit bigoted, but he's working on it. You think he will succeed? Well, he knows. I will kick his ass if he doesn't. I will get going then. Later's deal. This place has some magic. I like it. Oh, I could sit alone and ponder. I don't want to do that yet. Can I do the seeing? Couldn't get enough of me? I had a case of craving. Come on, just saying hi and passing by.
Hi, bye.
Until next time. Roger! Hello, young fellow. I'm Roger Betty. Pleasure to meet you. Hi. I'm Robert. Forgive me for being blunt, but I'm a doctor. What's the nature of your affliction? Never seen anything like it. Can I see? I'm not sure it's complicated. I'm happy to hear if you ever want an ex-professional opinion. Best to have these things checked out. You don't sound too good yourself. Yeah, I'm rather afraid I'll come down with a respiratory condition. Is it serious? No, nothing of you are botanicals that some rest won't fix. Can I help? That would be very kind of you. I got my hands full of with everyone's else requests. I'm your command. I think a cup of tea would do me good, but I need some herbs. You can find them in the forest area nearby and on the farm. Joshua was just about to go, you can keep him company. Joshua, shall we go on an adventure? Dude, I'm not fucking 12. I love this reaction. Sorry. Go on, Joshua. It will do you both good. What exactly do we need? Calendula, time and sage. Okay, we're going then. Geezer. The geezer regards you somewhat barely. Leave before she regards you more verily. Regard the geezer patiently. The geezer offers his tail feathers and looks more obliquely at you. I am your friend. The geezer hops gently in acknowledgement and settles calmly onto his haunches and makes what can only be described as a raspy purring sound. Just chilling with the geezer, learning from my problems. The geezer looks into your eyes and honks loudly. He likes spending time with you too. Sit with the geezer and not hit the bird together. I just befriended the geezer! Okay. So. Time? Okay, I have some time. I need sage and. Calendula here. Yeah. Calendula. And. I guess the sage will be here somewhere? No? Wait, what is this? Ah, sit alone. I actually wanna talk with Joshua. So what the fuck is that thing on your back? If I fucking know. Cool, welcome I guess. Dude, of a few words, huh? I like it. I don't know, maybe. I'm just gonna chill here. Don't tell that I'm smoking. Yo, that doesn't know you're smoking. I don't think so, he wouldn't like it. He's a doctor, maybe he knows best. You smoke? Not anymore. Sure, don't be a snitch. You happy here? It's a bit lonely, but it's the best place for me. Why are you guys here in the first place? There's trouble in the city for us. Would you rather be somewhere else? Don't know, it's boring here, but at least it's safe. Where were you before? I was too young to remember, Dad doesn't like to talk about it. Laters. Where's the third one? Where do I have everything? How does the herb searching go? Still working on it? Ah, thank you, I hope it's not too much trouble. I can talk with them now. B. Hey, how about right? Beautiful day we are having. You're cheerful. I try to be. Honestly, it's not too hard. This is your first time hanging with cities. There is like another life. Is it really that different? There's fewer people and music here. I've never been part of a community before. Doesn't it feel cool? I mean, Ryan annoys me, but we accept each other. There's one I can't leave behind. Ah, that's a shame. Maybe we'll change our minds. Sleep on it. Wanna play something together? Is that an invitation? I'm always up for a friendly jam. Have you got some? Here, have you got something I can play? Yay! I will get the harmonica for you. Just follow my lead. Take it away, maestro. I like this chapter, at least this part of it. Oh yeah! However, I didn't know you were this good with harmonica. They have these moments after all the fucked up shit what happened earlier. Hey again. Let's grab a YouTuber. Me and Andre? Oh yeah, okay, I didn't realize. Why is there a grab a YouTuber? Because he wanted to get a bigger house, I guess. Who knows with these grab folks? How long has he lived in there? Couple of years. He just moved in one day. Doesn't seem to mind the noises, so I thought, why not? Doesn't he affect the sound? He has a certain timbre to it. It's my signature sound now. What does he eat? Oh, just about anything. His favorite is carrot. Anyway, you don't miss your past life at all. Part of it, maybe, but this is my new life for every reason. What's the reason? I don't know yet. I might never know. You've been playing long. All my life, it's an extension of me. You play beautifully. Thanks. How were you taught? Parents got me lessons, I hated the teacher so in the end I just taught myself. Pretty impressive. I like to think so. I'd better get going. Bye. Wait, isn't it darker now? So maybe I can only spend a limited amount of moments with people. Leo. Hello again. I'm looking for Sage. Growing any? Sure, it's basically a perennial here. What you got in mind? I'm helping Roger with his cough, keeping myself busy. Ah, it's Dafer. You seem skeptical? Am I that transparent? What's the gossip? It just seems odd to me. The guy's a doctor, I never know one who believed in holistic medicine. Maybe it's trying something new. Maybe. Or maybe it's a smokescreen. For what? Maybe he's more real than he lets on. But doesn't want to worry Josh. Maybe he was never a doctor in the first place. People have told bigger lies. Maybe he didn't get the qualifications or something. Is he dying? Okay, I think you're spiraling now. That's enough about Roger. Sure, if you want the sage anyway? Yes, please. Can't do any harm. Here, I will cut you a few stamps. Appreciate it. No problem, bro. I'll get going. Later, Zio. Joshua didn't come back with you. He's still hanging out in the woods. Oh yeah, doing what? Looking at birds and trees. Ah, he's good despite his dad. You don't seem so bad at that, go. Ah, I would like to think so too, but what could you possibly be basing that assumption on? Wouldn't he be hard to run away and he stayed with you? You are somewhat damning me with faint praise there, but perhaps you are right. It's clear you are not seeing what fathers are capable of. Oh, I'm sorry for your tough upbringing. Thank you. Yeah, daytime. Excellent, thank you. Hope it helps. Thank you, Howard, and for spending time with Josh. Glad to be of help. Get well soon. Yeah, now I need to sit down here. No choice. Hey Howard, ready for dinner? Where's Larry? I'm not sure, he might turn off later. Does he often miss dinner? I'm afraid it's not unheard of, he has a history of substance abuse. Exactly, a history, it's in the past. I'm rather afraid it's a present issue. How often does this happen? Periodically, I don't know, once a month, not many folks here have guessed it, but as a doctor I can't help but notice some of the symptoms. That fucker lies straight to my face. He hides it well, he's a good guy. Everyone trusts him, I don't think it's our place to ruin that. You're right, let's just enjoy this dinner. It's his business. This reminds me to Road 96, I just realized. The campfire part. Even more. Oh, life is strange too. Driving me sane, driving me home, crawling through the wind. Oh, my beef is getting worse and worse. Don't massacre everyone. Life was morning to morning to morning, revoltingly same. The chase for the state or reaction, not everyone claims. The warmth of parents' hands is what I've been missing. Okay, so what's happening? Am I supposed to walk? Oh. Are we waiting for Larry? This song is beautiful, I love it. I wonder if it's a real song, or they wrote it specific for the game. But if it's really, it really fits this situation. Okay, so I don't think I'm bored because I could skip the cutscene. That it's not a vision blurry, but the fire exceeds. What is this sound? This music? Oh! Clarissa! Did they catch Larry and killed him maybe? Was yourself? What have you been? What are you? What have you aspired to become? I'm a person. I am what others see in me. That is just a small fraction of your externalized identity. What does it mean to truly show someone every facet of what makes you you? To reach out, to demand them to examine me, to look through their eyes at my own humanity. Love yourself through the love of others. Know yourself through the small rituals of truth. We are all one, breathing in unison, rhythmically becoming, pulsating. I am. We are. Okay. Anyway, thank you for watching. This was all for this episode, and in the next one we will finish the story, I'm quite sure of it. I really don't know what will happen. I'm quite sure it won't be a happy ending. Oh, and the tumor just became even bigger, I think. But anyway, won't waste the time, because I can't wait to continue this, and most likely I will continue right away. So thank you for watching once again, and bye.